everyone. This is the first episode of Azabu Minna-no Radio. I am Alina Hayashi, and I will be the host of the show for this round. The show is created by Minayoku, a community organization of Azabu Regional City Office, and we will be sharing Azabu Region's latest news and active organizations. You may be wondering, what is Minayoku? But don't worry, the staff from Azabu Regional City Office will explain it to us in a moment, so please stay with us. To start off, we will be explaining how this radio was created. Recently, most people, especially the younger generation, are using services like Instagram or Twitter as a source of information. The tools for sharing information has changed over the years from newspapers, radios, TVs, to social media. And the incredible thing is that none of these tools have died out yet. Walking while on the phone can be dangerous, and from experience, we understand that looking at the screen for a long time can be very tiring. So, we decided to use an audio stream, the radio, to connect with you all. And to make the radio accessible to everyone, we have decided to stream it on YouTube. Now, let's have a word from Chief Itabashi from the Azabu Regional City Office Collaboration Project section, who will be explaining Minayoku for us, read by Ryose Watanabe.
Thank you, and I'll be speaking on behalf of Mr. Itabashi. Minayoku is a program designed to discover and nurture individuals who work as a community supporters in hopes of creating new connections within the community. Every year, the Azabu Regional City Office gathers individuals interested in contributing to Azabu District's community activities and recruited a total of 11 participants last year. Within the 7 days of the program, they shared regional issues and characteristics, conducted experimental learning, and proposed project designs.
What are some things they have done so far?
The program begins with getting to know more about the community, so we got together with the local residents and took part in helping with festivals. Also, we have gone to places like Setagaya Ward and Miyashiro Town in Saitama to take a look at what other similar programs are offering. During the discussions, the first characteristic of Azabu District that pops up to our mind is, it's famous for its hills. It's also comprised of many famous shopping streets such as Roppongi and Azabu Juban, and has numerous embassies with many foreigners from numerous different backgrounds residing in its area. One of the major challenges in the Azabu District is that the number of individuals willing to participate in the town council and neighborhood association activities is a little short. And this is where Minayoku comes in. Within the unique characteristics of the Azabu District, Minayoku plays an important role in coming up with ideas to solve local issues.
What are some ideas that have been launched so far?
Until now, we have launched ideas and thoughts such as having the children run errands or otsukai so the community can watch over them together in order to enhance connections within the district, and creating a system so that in times of sudden rain on the hillsides, neighbors can pick up each other by car, thus creating a relationship of mutual assistance, or creating international cultural exchanges from various backgrounds and nationalities through hosting tea parties. And finally, this very Azabu Minna-no Radio was also an idea launched by last year's Minayoku. We hope that this radio program will provide opportunities for the people in the Azabu District to connect with one another and make the region better for everyone.
Thank you for the wonderful introduction. We have started this English version for the many English speakers that live in the Azabu area, as well as for the people who want to study English. Now it's about time we introduce the members of this radio program. I am Elena Hayashi, the host for today. Next to me is Inoue-san, who is mainly in charge of the management of Azabu Minna-no Radio. In charge of this English version are us students from the international course of Hiroo Gakuen Senior High School, me, Elena Hayashi, Ayaka Katayama, Ryosei Watanabe, and the Japanese host for today, Shin Morimoto. We will be rotating our roles as the program goes on. Now, we have an announcement.
Yes, we are looking for people willing to participate in this year's Minayoku program. It will be held 7 times, starting from 23rd and 30th of September, 14th and 28th of October, 11th and 25th of November, and finally the 16th of December, all on Saturdays and from 1 to 5pm. Through the activities, you can actively engage with the local community. You will also receive a certificate of completion on the last day. Anyone is welcome to apply. The application period is from Monday 21st August to Wednesday 20th September. A preliminary orientation will be held on Saturday 9th of September. Please refer to the 62nd issue of the community information paper, the Azabu, or the 21st August issue of the PR Minato for application information. For the activities of the past Minayoku graduates, please refer to the Azabu number 45, 59, and 62. You can also see the past projects from the link down below in the description. Application info will be posted soon as well. If you are in any way interested in taking part with community activities, please don't hesitate to apply.
Moving on to news from Hiroo Gakuen. Hiroo Gakuen has been holding after-school English session to young children from grade 1 to grade 3. They are tutored by alumnums, current high schoolers, and native English-speaking teachers. Students from different schools can play and learn with English. For more information, please look up Hiroo Gakuen Little Heroes or access the link in bio.
We are all very nervous because this is our first time conducting this radio program. We will continue to make the program enjoyable and informative as we work through trial and error. We will be posting on Instagram, Threads, and Notes, so please follow us on there too. We will also be sending out information from the Azabu District General Branch Office's Twitter feed. We're always looking for interesting topics, groups, and personalities who would like to be featured, so feel free to reach out to us. Please subscribe to our channel, and thank you for staying with us to the end. Stay hydrated, and enjoy the rest of summer.